Hey there, Ms. Black Love. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
That's good. Do you feel like talking today?
Sure.
Great. Who do you want to talk about?
My grandma's house.
Okay. Okay, Ms. Black Love, so where shall we start?
Yeah.
Where you at? Where you at, twin?
Huh?
Where you at, twin?
Dude, what are you talking
about? Where you at, nigga?
I'm at home. You outside.
Damn, I'm about to tell you, meet me.
Wait. No, I can't do that, man. I just came from over there.
Where you just came from? Where?
Yo, you just said you're coming to pick them up, bro.
I know, but I didn't think you would die.
Oh, man. Ain't gonna pick them up.
Damn. Nobody, nobody. I forgot he was an A1. But still, though, they're working
the
part. Oh my God.
That first feel, man. Josephine, she was one of the best.
She was amazing. She had it all.
She was beautiful.
She had kids. She made sure she came to church. She did what most people couldn't do.
Unfortunately, it was her last time.
You know, we always talk about how funny life is and how it adds a character, how it adds art. And we always talk about the grief beyond our people that we love. And the love doesn't start giving. It doesn't end just because expiration dates on our lives. My grandmother was one of the people that her expiration came unexpectedly to some, and for most of us, we already knew.
My grandma Josephine used to always tell my little chill like my dad, I used to be like, grandma, I already know. She say, how's life? I be like, it good, grandma. How she be doing? She be like, she be doing all right, you know, trying to make it. And then I remember we took some pictures together. And when the clip rolling, she gonna show y'all the pictures.
Yeah, so we just doing this just to show our appreciation, you know, after her death and then for her birthday, because we never had a chance to actually celebrate it. And today we're going to honor her.
Right.
As you can tell, everyone had this relieving feeling. All the emotion was riled up. Everything that you can expect.
She giving life. Giving life into all of us where we couldn't even self-describe it ourselves, because we know that we're part of our grandmother. And for the fact that to me to try to understand my grandmother and try to understand the mystery and ask the question that I wanted to ask, I don't even think I need to ask them, because I see it through my whole entire family. My whole entire family. I'm talking about the laughters. The joking, the sense of humor, the dark sense of humor is at that. We are a quirky, weird family. We are a weird family. And I don't care anybody who gets offended by that. We are weird. We already know. We accept our weirdness. If you ain't down with the cause, then you lost. We are one of the family that we will probably get upset and it will go so beyond. We are one of the family that we can be country and sophisticated at the same time.
We are the kind of family, like, we'll bring the litness, we'll bring the party, we'll bring the laughter, we'll be goofy. We'll just have a great time. We just know how to lighten up the room. Like, even if you feel like you just sitting there, you got a lot on your mind, we're going to bring that out of you. We're one of the family that will bring the sadness out of you. And we don't like to sit in, you know, sad spaces. So that's our family. Like,
Supersonic.
Oh! Hey!
get up and go on with your life. It's all right. Sit around, be depressed for a minute, cry about it, do whatever you have to, but don't stay there too long. Get up and go on with your life. So you know what this is what I learned in all these years on this earth. If somebody want to walk out of your life, let them go.
Nobody ever told me that grief felt so much like fear. It's a powerful statement, fear. But fear of what? The fear of losing yourself. The fear of growing old alone. The fear that this intense pain will never stop.
There will be seasons where we will suffer. There will be seasons of real pain. You respond in those moments.
Let folks go, son. Some people come in your life for a lifetime. Some come for a season. You got to know which is which. And you're going to always mess up when you mix them seasonal people up with lifetime expectations. But if you find you two or three people in your life that's like the roots at the bottom of that tree, you are blessed, because that's them the kind of people that ain't going nowhere. They ain't worried about being seen. Don't nobody have to know that they know you. They ain't got to know what they're doing for you. But if them roots wasn't there, that tree couldn't live. You understand? And they ain't got a whole, a tree can have 100 million branches, but only a few roots down at the bottom to make sure it get everything it needs. I'm telling you, son, when you get you some roots, hold on to them, but the rest of them, let it go. Just let it go. Let folks go. And it'll get easy. I promise you, every day it'll get easier and easier and easier, but you just got to make it through. You hear me, sonny? And CP, you got to learn how to be by yourself, son. People have to learn how to be alone. I don't understand all these people. Oh, I need somebody. Lord, where's my man? Lord, where's my woman? That is crazy as hell. If you don't know how to be by yourself, what you gonna do with somebody else? You got to go. This is mine. You hear me, sonny? You better hear me for sure. If somebody wanna walk out of your life, let them go.
She delightful. She spoke her mind. She spoke in no filter.
When the water's rushing up your neck and the ground leaves your feet.
Some of y'all got three.
Who need one? Who need one?
I got one.
Y'all got one. Who need one?
I got one right here.
Cause what's the worst it could be? In need of more than just the chick to check to get free. Not trying to get by.
I'm trying to get free.
Not trying to get by.
This for Uncle Bobby.
We're gathered here to honor a celebration for the living, for life, and to pay respect to everyone that had passed on before us. And we know that we're all here now, and we give thanks and we honor and respect everybody here now, because we never know when we'll see each other again. So we thank God. We honor him, we honor you, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, just for another opportunity, Lord, just be able to gather in fellowship one with another. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I'm trying to get free. I'm trying to get free. I'm not
talking on the phone? I thought you just got saved.